Turner wrote a letter to his wife 75 years ago when he was in the Navy away from her. And Amy Carter got up to read the letter because Jimmy Carter can't speak the way he used to speak anymore. Rosalind wanted some of his voice to be heard in the context of the funeral service. And this is what he wrote in the letter. This is the beginning of the Advent season for me practicing patience. Well, nothing to be sorry for, so private patience is working. As you know, in a minute, it's still.
Do what we
trying to fit something in that we did last year to the way we are this year. There's something new. Last year was the first Christmas of the Ukraine war. Today, this year, is the second. But also now, with the Israeli, Palestine, and Hamas, our world is different. What's going on with the nation regarding our elections beginning again, that divide. What caught my mind during the week that gives me hope was that it's an article that said Mitch McConnell said to Chuck Schumer, extraordinary speech. They're not the best of friends, majority leader and minority leader. But Chuck Schumer took to the floor to speak from his experience as Jewish and told everyone in the Senate and whoever was watching that for the Jews, what's happening is a crisis. For everybody else, it's just a problem. And for many, it's absolutely nothing. But that can be said of anything, or of any group that has experienced something. For the ones who are going through it, it's a crisis. For some of us, it's get over it. For some, it's what's wrong with them. Someone said, well, there's three kinds of people. Those who watch things happen, those who make things happen, and those who wonder about them. What kind are you? So at the end of Chuck Schumer's speech, which was quite emotional, a couple of times he paused and he was in tears because it affected him, his family, his own culture. Mitch McConnell got up and he spoke and said, that was one of the most extraordinary speeches that I ever heard. When I saw that and read that, I just thought, why can't there be more of that? Why can't there be more of that? We would be in a different space if there was. But that all begins at home. Not in the Congress. Begins at home as we watch our children. We either watch them for what they did right, or we watch them for what we did wrong. And when they do things wrong, you could be sure that our voice is a little different than when they do things wrong. It's almost we need to remark that our children become what we tell them or say, or how we say it, or how we do it. And the same with us. That beautiful reading that I started with about pointing out the sparks of light in yourselves, you all have. And that beautiful first reading that said, God's still making you. He's the potter, you're the clay, you're the handiwork of God. It continues to work with you. He's not done with you. He's not done until you close your eyes and work. So it's nice to begin the first Sunday of Advent with you. It's nice to see you looking at me, and I'm looking at you. And thinking 3 years ago we would be doing this, but today we are. And Senator Dale Connor said that I'm just the older I get, a little more aware of all the blessings I have. It's just so many. It's a litany of thanksgiving. And I choose to live on that so that I can be a little spark of light in the midst of darkness. That is